As the name suggests, solar chula makes use of solar energy. Hence, it does not incur any cost to use it. As wood or coal is not used, there is no pollution and hence it is good for health. WOTR introduced these solar chulas at the primary schools and for students of Anganwadi for their midday meals. Solar chula is designed in such a way that a concave aluminium reflector shield is placed on the stainless steel frame. This reflector can be rotated in 180 degrees. It works as a mirror to reflect sun rays and point them at a specific point. This is the point where the pressure cooker should be placed. Due to sun's strong rays, the aluminium vessel heats up and any food kept inside the vessel gets cooked. Points to be considered for installing the chula. Obviously, it should be kept where there is ample sunlight. Keep all the ingredients required for cooking handy, so there is no running around at the cooking time. When not in use, place the chula in such a way as to not damage the reflector shield and cause any injury to people around. Keep it on a firm base where cooker does not fall off or tip while moving. Before you start cooking, remove the lock. Food items like rice, lentils, vegetables can be cooked easily using solar chula and without hampering their taste. It can cook food for almost 40 people at a time. 5 kg rice can be cooked in an hour. Apply black color paint to the bottom of pressure cooker to be used in the solar chula for faster cooking. A paint brush and black color paint can is provided with the chula. If the black color coating fades, apply a new one as soon as possible. Avoid scrubbing over the paint while washing the pressure cooker. You must be wondering why to apply black paint. The reason is that black color helps in absorbing sun's energy, thereby raising the temperature and cooking the food faster. Remember to add the ingredients like oil, salt, spices, etc. at once to the food to be cooked. Close the pressure cooker lid and then keep it on the chula. Strong sun rays are emitted because of the reflection, so always use sun goggles to avoid strain on your eyes. Adjust the shield in such a way that the pressure cooker always is in the direction of the sun. There is an indicator bar on the side of the chula. It should always stimulate 12 noon position. That is, there should not be any shadow. It is not required to monitor the chula constantly. This extra time can be used fruitfully for any other work. When the whistle of the cooker blows, it means the food is almost cooked and ready. Wait for 3 whistles and then remove the pressure cooker from the chula and keep it aside in the shade for 5 minutes. After the pressure cooker cools down, remove the lid. There is no extra expense in maintaining the chula. Only clean it regularly as dust and grime can reduce its effectiveness. While maintaining the aluminium reflectors, keep it in mind that any scrubbing or scratches on it will make the chula unusable. Just sprinkle some water on the reflectors and wipe with cloth or plastic and make sure you do not accidentally touch the sharp corners as it may cut your hand. So what are the rules for this new type of cooking method like solar chula? First and foremost is there should be ample sunlight, otherwise you cannot use this chula. If it is cloudy, then cooking time increases drastically, and in rainy season, you will have to use alternate method of cooking. One cannot make chapatis or rotis as they have to be constantly flipped, and it is not possible to be near the chula in the hot sun for a long time. Also, the food items that need constant stirring cannot be cooked on this chula. As long as there is solar energy, we can use this solar chula, which is strong, sturdy, clean, and healthy. You can use this up to 8 months of the year without worrying of any alternate expensive fuels.